Welcome to Castin Cajun. We're your hosts, Tony Fontenot
and Bo Grafton.
Fishing out of Bridgeside Marina, where Buggy hooked us up with some of the liveliest croakers on the island. We targeted mangrove snapper and hopefully a couple of lemon fish. Bo, tell us who's with us.
Fishing with us today is my little sister, Joan McMaster, her husband, Ryan McMaster, also Staff Sergeant Dex Legendre, the mangrove master.
U.S. Army.
My dad from North Louisiana, Hoyt Grafton, who is the white perch master, or like they say it on here, Sockelet master.
So get ready for an exciting half hour with Castin Cajun.
Castin Cajun is brought to you by Thibodeau Regional Medical Center for expert, compassionate care. Grafton Dermatology, specializing in diseases of the skin, hair, nails, and cosmetic surgery. Cajun Home Improvements, the last roof you'll ever buy. Don's Wholesale, your truck superstore with the largest selection of pre-owned trucks in Louisiana. HomeOfTravel.com, experience world-class fishing in the heart of Louisiana. Visit HomeOfTravel.com. And by Tony Sacheries, makes everything taste great.
All right, we just pulled up to a rig, trying for a few cobia, mangroves. Dex just hit something big. I don't know, it's shaking his head, maybe a bonita, but it's fighting good, so we'll see what happens.
What you got, man?
Looks like a bonita.
I thought we were after cobia.
Trying for him. Bonita.
We finally got a cobia. We're catching mangrove all day long. Picked up the big camera. On the way in, we stopped at this single rig. And it's like, look like Ryan.
Yeah.
Like Ryan, you got it.
Got a big cobia.
Ryan?
Cobia, Joan. Yeah, boy, that's what you wanted. Woo!
Oh, yeah.
Scream.
Yeah.
Don't horse it. Let him wear himself out. Joan, if I bring the sucker in.
Oh, you lost
him. Oh, no. He spit it out.
Fish spit the hook. He was pulling drag and everything, so I thought he was hooked good, but apparently he was just holding on.
Yeah.
See if we can get him to hit again. Look like Dr. Grafton, Bo's dad, might have hooked that same cobia or another one.
There you go. I done lost one today.
Bonita.
The bonita.
Yeah.
How about this?
Pops, your first cobia. What do you think?
That ain't a cobia. That's a fake cobia.
My brother-in-law, Ryan McMaster, from Shreveport, Louisiana. Hooked up. Oh, yeah. I think it's a big red snapper. Oh yeah. Nice.
Oh yeah.
Elusive red snapper?
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty. We're too far out, guys, so we're gonna release him. We might try for some little ones on the way back in. They just get beat up in that 10-mile limit. Good one, Ryan.
Thank you.
Go ahead, a cobia coming around here.
Oh, yeah.
Good job, buddy. I got it. I really got it. Nice one. About 12 and a half inches. I'll go measure. Hooked up, hooked up. All right, Staff Sergeant. Hey, babe. Good one. Go measure him, too. Another pretty fish. Take these, boy, you cut the head off, scale them, gut them, put some slashes in it and fry that whole. Cuban snapper. It's a bomb. Right there. Ah, hooked up. What I like to do, what I like to do is when they're fishing in the front, we've got a crew boat right there, so there's a lot of wheel wash going on. So I'll put a couple of little weights on there, same fluorocarbon, drop it down with a live mullet or a live croaker. 15 count, maybe, hooked up in the front. You'll catch them. Little mangrove. I've been missing him. Good one, good one, good one. Get him, Dex. Get him out. Good job, Dex. Baby.
Dex is putting a hurting on him.
Bo, little Bo calls Dex the mangrove master.
All right.
Get him, Tony. Get him, Tony. Oh, God. In the boat. Good job.
Tastes just as good as red snapper. Don't get quite as big.
They're better than red snapper, huh?
Both of them are better than red snapper.
I like them better.
And you can catch them year-round in federal water.
Hooked up, man. Oh, yeah.
You got Bo.
Big mangrove, big mangrove. Woo! I'm hoarse. Or snapper.
My cold today is Bo's twin brother, Froggy.
I got a cold. Ah, little snapper. That's all right.
Oh, wrong flavor?
Wrong flavor.
Right size.
Wrong flavor, right size. Pretty fish. What you got, buddy?
What you got, Ryan? Ryan. Oh, Bo's got one too. Woo!
Oh, he got off.
Oh. A red snapper.
Pretty fish.
We were catching a lot of mangroves at the last rig we were at. Thunderstorms have been chasing us around, so we decided to move. We're gonna see if we can catch some bigger ones. So don't go away, we'll be right back.
What's that? I got him. Good one, bud. Nice. Get him, Pop. Rail, rail, rail. Good job. I got him. Good job, Pop.
Get him, Doc. Hello. Nice having your dad out here with us. No, I lost mine last year, so it makes me appreciate it more.
You know, when we were young, I taught him everything he knows, but now he's teaching me about all this saltwater stuff.
There you go.
That's right.
Nothing wrong with that.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
He still teaches me about crappie fishing, sockeye. Reel him in, boy.
I think this is a good one, if it's not red.
Come here, Joan. Come here, Joan. Where you at, Joan?
Double.
I'm trying to give it to you. Hang on, he's trying to get back in the rig. Hang on. Whoa, shit. Come on, hustle. Hooked up, hooked up. Hooked up back here, Gary.
He got it, he got them both.
Oh,
that's a net, that mangrove.
That's a monster.
Woo! That's what
I'm
talking about.
Get him, get him, get him, Joan. We got another one coming in, a big one.
All right, let me get this one out the net.
We got a big one back here.
All right, get back there.
Good one, Tony. No, that's a mangrove.
Back yeah.
It's a big one. In the boat, in the net, in the net. Good job, good job. That's a monster. Sweet.
Well, like we said, we moved rigs, not only because the storms were chasing us, but to try to catch some bigger snapper. Looks like it's working. And by the way, this is Bo's favorite sister, Joan. All right, Dex, explain to everybody what you should look for and how you determine which leg of the rig you set up on.
All right, so right now it's easier for everybody to fish because we're down current. So the current's coming this way. It's keeping the boat off the rig so the captain doesn't have to stay behind the wheel. So what you could do is you get the chum, you throw it into the rig just like you're going to cast your bait. As you do that, you want to feed out the line to let the bait drift with the current.
Free spool.
So if you're using a croaker, you want to keep make sure you got a live one. If it starts to die, doesn't swim right, it won't hit it. Dead bait, you want it to float with the current as much as possible. One of the things you're looking for too is as you cast, even though you're letting out that line, you don't want too much slack. Too much slack will make your bait float back up or pull away from the rig quicker.
Now when you're talking about dead bait, you mean like the what we're chumming with, the sardines, not a dead croaker. Like he was saying, if your croaker's dead, throw it away and get a live one.
Yeah, but if you're using sardines, just take a little chunk, hook it on, throw some chum out, and then let it float with it. You want to make it look like the same. That's why I use the fluorocarbon, because these fish are pretty sharp.
With these circle hooks, I like to hide the hook too. Embedded good inside the meat. All right. Caught a few on the chum, pieces of sardine. Now I'm trying with a live croaker.
Get him pop, reel, reel. You got a reel, you got a reel, you got a reel. There you go. Oh, hooked up. Oh.
And Mo, you got hopefully a big mangrove.
Something big. It's pulling the wrong way though. Right, he's trying to get back in the rig now.
I want to see the color of his eyes.
Watch your line, Pop. Watch your line. Get out your lines out.
Ooh, that is a big mangrove. Wow. Good job, Bo.
Woo. So what I'm doing here is we're catching some bigger ones. Often I'll let it drift out a little further, and as it gets deeper, those big mangrove will be down deeper. They'll hit that thing 20, 30, 40 feet deep sometime. So be patient. If you don't get them up in the rig, let it drift out with the current. Never let the line get taut, because if it does, they see a change in that drift. Let it drift out, and if you're stuck in the back of the boat like I am sometimes, put a little weight on there, 15 count down, you'll still catch the big ones. Good luck, guys. So what I'm doing, guys, I'm watching that line. As long as it stays slack, I'm good. But the minute I see it straighten out, or I see it start to run, that's when you want to close your bail and get ready. You don't want to rip it. There he goes. He hit it. Just want to close it and reel. He's on. Oh, shit. He got off. That's a general technique, though. There's more than one way to hook a croaker. I like to hook them through the back like this because it helps them swim down a little bit. Some of my buddies like to hook them through the tail. Some people through the eye. Sometimes it changes. Remember, mangrove snapping, you're always changing your strategy, always changing your tactics. Get out there, give it a try. Hardtail, get him, Pop. Right behind you, right behind you. Hooked up.
Oh, a little Jack Revelle. Uh-oh. Fish on. Oh, a good one. I'm gonna get past the duck. You gotta walk away from the rig. Cause they will get in there. What I got here? What I got here? Fighting like a snapper. On a sardine. Oh, yeah.
Oh, big one, big one, Dax. Big one, big one, big one. Nice one. There he goes.
Oh! Staff Sergeant Dex Legendre to the rescue.
Get him, Dex. That's a nice one, baby.
Yes, indeed.
Get him, Tony.
One more for the ride home. In the words of Captain T. Kip Plaisance.
All right, guys, we're going to commercial break. Y'all stay tuned for some more mangrove action. Some big boys.
Woo! This Castin Cajun cooking segment is brought to you by Tony Sashery's makes everything taste great.
Well, you've seen that Luke's pretty good at catching fish. He's really good at selling vehicles. Now we're gonna find out how he is at cooking jambalaya in a rice cooker.
One of the things that I realized is it's so much easier to cook it in a rice pot. If you're just coming home and you're ready to just throw something together, it's real easy for the wife to do it, you to do it. You get some brownie points if you do that. Basically, you get 2 pounds of sausage. You cut them up as thin as you want them. You get one onion, one bell pepper. Now the kids, my kids for instance, don't really like the onions too much. So I cheat, I blend them. So what we're gonna do is we put them in the food processor and puree.
That way they don't know.
That way they don't know. Plus you still get your flavor and it actually cooks faster. That way you don't have to worry about the onions still being crunchy or anything like that.
So just like the sausage, the bell pepper, onions, the thinner you slice it, the faster it cooks.
Faster it cooks. The beauty of it is we're gonna throw everything in the rice pot at one time.
And I see you have a small green bell pepper and a small red bell pepper.
I even had this one outside of the plant.
It's out in your garden?
Out of the plant.
Oh, yeah. So we have here beef broth.
Basically, you're gonna have 3 cups of rice, which is all pre-measured, and 4 cups of broth. You can use beef, you can use chicken. This recipe can be used basically shrimp. I mean, you can use a seafood stock if you're gonna do the shrimp or crawfish or whatever you want. Still comes out the same way.
I always chop my stuff by hand, man. I'm gonna have to get one of these little things.
Try it, since you wanna buy one.
Just push the button. Wow.
Even Tony can do it. If we put a little water in it, it'll make it go down faster. Okay. That way it's a little easier. It'll take it from the bottom to the top.
So we're gonna make a puree anyway. Then you get the flavor, and then people who are scared to eat vegetables, we eat it anyway. Say bon comme ça.
Add 1/2 stick of butter. Butter will give it a little bit more oily, so it actually won't stick. Your rice will be a little bit more fluffy.
Kind of a creamy oily though, huh?
Yes, sir.
Unlike cooking oil.
Do it all at once. Hold that so it don't come out.
Yeah, that might not taste too good.
The blade might hurt a little bit. Put a little splash of Tony Sashery's Bold. Give it a lot more heat.
I like that bowl. It's got a little more cayenne pepper in it. I like that.
Add our sausage up in there. Have 2 pounds of sausage all cut up.
Is this smoked sausage?
It is smoked sausage. Any variation you'd like to use. This one in particular is one of my favorites. It's a local place in the area. Baudouin's Sausage Kitchen here.
It's a good Cajun name.
It's a Cajun boy sausage is what it's called. It's a normal rice pot. Put it on, set it. You want to stir occasionally, just making sure that everything's mixing well in the pot, making sure that everything's cooking well. Smells good.
Smells good.
Stir it up, see how it's cooking up.
Smells like jambalaya. Looks like jambalaya.
Got a consistency of jambalaya. After it's all cooked, you should let it sit for about 30 minutes. You can actually go ahead and plate it. Why don't you try it out?
Since I drove almost 2 hours to get here, you think I'll be able to take some of this home?
You can take the whole pot.
Deal. Delicious, folks. You saw how simple it was to prepare. Try it at home. shoot us an email, let us know what you think. And if you're looking for a deal on a truck, go see Luke at Don's Wholesale
in Broussard.
All right, guys, we had a great time today. We caught some awesome mangrove snapper, great fishing out of Grand Isle, Louisiana. If we'd have just got those two big cobia, we'd be in business.
Well, folks, as always, we got to give a special thanks to our military, both our active troops and our veterans. Speaking of, this is one of our active troops right here, Staff Sergeant Dex Legendre, the Mangrove Master. So until next time, keep on casting. Boudreaux and Thibodeau love to fish, but they could never afford a boat. So they heard about this place where you could rent one and fish a private lake. They go down there, rent a boat. What do you know? They catch a boatload of fish. So Thibodeau says, man, Boudreaux, we gotta come back over here. I hope we can find the fish again. Boudreaux takes out his pocket knife and he carves an X on the side of the boat. Thibodeau says, what's that for? He said, this is where the fish were biting. Thibodeau said, Boudreaux, that's stupid. What if we don't get the same boat?